Hi, this is Greg, and we're back in ATS's lab, and we're going to talk about the ultra-cool family of CPU coolers that we have here. So we're going to talk about mounting these and how they're used, and just other some details about their function. So to introduce our ultra-cool family, first we have our dual-flow heatsink. So our dual-flow heatsink has really high-density fins, which have intakes on both sides of the heatsink, and then the air exits the blower through here. So our quad flow has the same concept, except it has intakes on all four sides of the heatsink, and that enable for really dense PCB layouts and stuff like that. It helps to get the air in from all sides of the heatsink. In addition to those active solutions, we have a line of passive CPU coolers, which we call our fanless CPU line. So these heat sinks don't have a blower. And like the dual flow and quad flow heat sinks, they also have the grease pre-applied. So when you receive these heat sinks, they have a seal on here and they have packaging that protects the grease. And that's pre-applied right here. It's high performance thermal grease. So we'll show you how to attach these to the heat sink. These heat sinks are designed for the Intel LG sockets LGA 2011 square and the 2066, which is also known as socket R. And it'll basically attach to anything that has the 80 by 80 millimeter hole pattern and the M4 screw attachment. So with the Intel sockets, that's all built in right there, so our heat sinks screw directly to that socket. So on this motherboard, we're going to demonstrate with our quad flow heat sink, because in use, we'd have memory on each side of the CPU, and it's a pretty dense layout. So the quad flow will have the intakes on all sides of the heat sink for better airflow. And then in addition, we're going to point the blower this way so that the exhaust air will move over this heat sink and it will keep those components cool as well. So as we mentioned before, the grease would be pre-applied on this heat sink, but this one is clean just for demonstration purposes. But you just place it right on top, and the screws kind of engage in those standoffs to begin with, so it's already kind of lined up. So when we tighten this, we do want to use a diagonal approach, and we'll also tighten it in stages just so it goes down evenly. So you want to hold it, you want to apply a little bit of pressure just to hold it down so that it doesn't tip when you start to tighten these screws. So then you just have to push down a little bit on the screw and turn it until it engages a few turns. And then you come over to the opposite corner, and we'll do the same thing. And then, so at this point, it's already level mounted in there. And then we'll do the diagonal opposite corner. That's it. So now we'll finish tightening these screws until they bottom out. And now the heatsink is fully installed with the appropriate mounting pressure. These springs are pretty strong, so that they'll minimize the thermal resistance in that interface in the bottom. So the active heatsinks we have, the dual flow and the quad flow heatsinks, have a 4-pin fan header. So this will fit standard motherboard fan headers. So if you have a 4-pin header, which is on this board, that enables that gives the 12 volt power to the fan, as well as enabling the RPM control with the PWM signal. And it also has the tack signal, so your computer can monitor the actual speed of the fan. If you have a 3-pin motherboard fan header, this will also plug right on, but the fan will just run at 100% speed all the time because there will not be a PWM control. And it's as easy as that. UltraCool line of heat sinks can also be used on a motherboard that doesn't necessarily have the Intel sockets on there. So if you have any other kind of CPU on your motherboard and you want to use our high performance coolers, we do have this mounting bracket available, which is a stiffener plate and the mounting bracket. And this part number we refer to as ATS-HK379. So the datasheet will have the specific mechanical information, but all you need to do is have the four mounting holes on that 80 millimeter square pattern, and the backing plate goes on the back of the board, and these standoffs will pass through the PCB, and then that will provide the mounting for your heatsink that goes right on top. So then the PCB and your component will be sandwiched in between this backing plate and the heatsink. So for specific pressure information, that depends on the thickness of the PCB and the height of the component, as well as the size of the component. And you can give us a call here at ATS, and we'd be glad to help you figure out the exact pressure that you can expect. And if you need to customize some springs or something to adjust that mounting hardware, we'd be glad to help you out. So for questions on the mounting and details, like we just talked about with the mounting pressures, you can visit our website at www.qats.com, and you can contact us through our website.